Hi, I'm Li Hao. In the last video, we talked about how we register component lifecycle events such as on mount, on destroy, before update, and after update. We talked about some of the do's and don'ts about registering them. For example, you have to call them during the component initialization. We briefly touched about when they will be called. But today in this video, I want to dive slightly deeper into the on-mount component lifecycle. So let's take a look at the two examples that I prepared for you for on-mount. So over here, I have my app.svelte that renders two examples. If the show is true, so I use a checkbox to turn that on and off. So what are the use case of a good example use case of using on-mount? Well, I can think of two, but of course there's a lot more. So the first one is I use on-mount to set an interval, right? So you wouldn't want to kick off this interval of like some events that you're doing during interval. This should be only triggered, started when your component is mounted onto the DOM, right? Over here, I set an interval on every second so that I can see the counter increase by one every second. And then the second example that I can think of is using on-mounts to fetch data. So if you use a server-side rendering and a client-side hydration kind of model where you want to fetch some data in the client side, so mainly usually because you want this data is less important, it's probably showing up later on, so you are able, you're okay to fetch them later on in the client side, then probably you can add it in the on-mount lifecycle, right? You wouldn't want to do it in like component initialization because that will be actually be triggered by the server-side rendering, right? During server-side rendering, you would want this to only happen in a client-side, then probably you add this fetch within on-mount. If it's purely client-side rendering, you don't have any server-side rendering, then you can fetch this during component initialization because the time difference isn't that much, and then probably you can even like fetch, make a network call way before your component is mounted so that when it's mounted, the data maybe it's already there. So on mount, so remember, you don't take my word for it that I say that on mount will not be fired during server-side rendering. Remind me, later on I will show you, we have to try everything so that you don't take any word from anyone. Right, but let's take a look at these two examples. So when I turn on this flag, you should be able to see the counter is incrementing, and also I fetch this data. And then also have, because on I added a console log, so on every interval you see that the console is logging in the log. But if I turn it off, you see that this is still running. It's still running, 33. Then 4.5, because we didn't clear the interval. This is another source of memory leak. We set an interval to run on mount, and then we didn't clear it up. And the next time when we mount this component again, we set off another timer, and we turn this off. See that there's two timers running at the same time now. So we need to remember to clean it up. So how do you do that in on mount? Maybe we can take this interval instead of setting it over here. We define the interval ID on top so that on destroy we have to remember to clear interval ID. Let me save this and hold on. Let me pass it over here. Let me save this and refresh because the old interval is still running. So if I come over here and I turn it on, console is running, and I turn it off, it's gone, right? That's great. We remember to clean up whatever we set it off during on mount. Of course, this is a bit wordy, like you have to remember to do an on mount and on destroy pair. And because this is a very common pattern that we usually do, so actually Svelte provides a way that you can do it all of this within just one on mount event lifecycle handler. So what you do is you can return a function in onMount, and this will be called when the component is destroyed. So you can have the interval ID over in within onMount and clean it up at the same time within the same event handler. So you can save a few keystrokes. You don't have to import onDestroy. You don't even need to define interval ID on top. You can do this, and hopefully it's more concise. So let's try this out. Turn it on. Console. I turn it off. It's gone. Right. So you can return a function in an onMount event handler so that it will clean up. It will be called when the component is destroyed so that it will do the cleanup necessary. Same thing goes for fetching. If you fetch and your component is destroyed, you don't really need the data anymore, then probably you can use abort controller and you return a function to abort the fetch. So if I take a look at the network tab over here, clear this up, and turn on and turn off immediately, you see that, hold on, I think this is returned now. Let's do it faster. Let's turn off. You see that this is being canceled, right? Because you don't need this data anymore. So remember to do, remember to clean up whenever you use onMount. Anything, there's a lot of things that can be cleaned up. So remember to do that, right? So timeout, intervals, fetches, there's a lot of things, right? So there you have it, onMount, and remember to clean up. So before we end this, I promise you I'm going to show you how to run this in a server-side rendering. So I'm going to save this and I'm going to download the project. And then come over here and compress this. Allow me for a while. I'm going to run this with my code editor. So I have VS Code open. And come over here. Most likely I need to install something. Right, so this one I'm going to change it to server-side rendering. So we're going to come over here, SSR. Wait, no. Right, I think it's the, generate, it's called generate. Come over here, terminal, install my dependency. And build my code. Okay, so actually this is not going to work because we're going to compile it as a server-side rendering. So I'm going to come over here, app.render props, empty props. I'm going to come over here, save the HTML. I'm going to just console it out. Build this again. And I'm going to run it. Oh man, what did I do? Build this. And run this. Yep, you can see my HTML is up. And you will notice that... Okay, so we haven't really console out anything in the onMount. So this is what we're going to try. See whether this onMount is being called. We can default to true so that you will show the example 1 and 2. Okay, let's build this again. And then run this. And as you can see over here, we did not run anything. We do not see anything on onMount. Right, so this 0 is this count over here, so we do render this. This image over here is the image, and we didn't see any onMount. So onMount is not fire during server-side rendering. Okay, hope that's clear. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have anything you'd like to ask, comments down below. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.